For many strength training exercises, we can choose the type of external resistance that we use. For example, in many barbell exercises, we can choose whether to use weights or accommodating resistance in the form of elastic bands or chains. And the type of external resistance that we use determines the results that we get from training. And this is mainly because the type of external resistance determines the point in the exercise range of motion where peak forces occur. For example, in the barbell squat, when we use weight, the peak forces occur at the bottom of the lift. And this is because there is gravity acting on the weight throughout the whole lift, but we have to overcome inertia in order to accelerate the barbell at the beginning of the lift. So the forces at the beginning of the lift, in the bottom position, are greater than they are throughout the rest of the lift. In contrast, if we were to use accommodating resistance for the same exercise by using either elastic bands or chains, then the increasing band tension or the increasing chain weight as we progressed upwards through the lift would cause the peak forces to occur somewhere towards the middle or the end of the lift. And the placement of this peak force at some point in the exercise range of motion has key effects on the results that we would get from training in the squat with either weight or accommodating resistance. So if we train using an exercise with weights or with accommodating resistance, then we see specific strength gains to the type of external resistance that we use. So for example, if we do the barbell squat with weights, then we would tend to improve our ability to squat with weight to a greater extent than our ability to squat with accommodating resistance. And conversely, if we were to squat in training with accommodating resistance, we'd improve our ability to squat with accommodating resistance to a greater extent than we would improve our ability to squat with weights. And underlying this specificity are several different types of adaption that occur because of the placement of the peak force in the exercise range of motion. Strength gains are specific to the type of external resistance we use for three reasons. Firstly, they're specific because of the joint angles that develop the largest gains in strength. Secondly, they're specific because of the velocities that experience the largest gains in strength. And thirdly, they are specific because of where they operate on the strength endurance continuum. Different types of external resistance necessarily cause joint angle specific strength gains because they cause peak forces to occur at different points in the exercise range of motion. So weight causes the peak forces to occur at the bottom of the lift. Accommodating resistance causes peak forces to occur towards the middle or the end of the lift. And this means that just like using full or partial ranges of motion, the muscle is stimulated most at either long, moderate, or short lengths. And this therefore leads to gains in strength that are greatest at either long, moderate, or short lengths. External resistance types also affect the speed that we can move with any given percentage of our one repetition maximum. So, for example, if we are using the squat exercise, then if we use free weights and use say 60% of our free weight squat one repetition maximum, then the bar would move more slowly than if we performed a squat with accommodating resistance with 60% of our one repetition maximum squat with accommodating resistance. And this difference in bar speed with any given load means that external resistance types affect velocity specific strength gains. So free weights tend to cause velocity-specific strength gains that favour low velocities, and accommodating resistance tends to cause velocity-specific strength gains that favour high velocities. And this is why we see greater gains in power when we perform a strength training program with accommodating resistance compared to with free weights. The type of external resistance we use also affects adaptions on the strength endurance continuum. So when we use free weight, the forces tend to peak quite early in the exercise range of motion and then reduce thereafter. When we use accommodating resistance, we can often create a situation in which the exercise is similarly difficult throughout the entire range of motion. And this causes a far greater metabolic demand on the muscle than the free weight equivalent. And subsequently, we tend to find that when we use accommodating resistance for an exercise, we improve our muscular endurance to a greater extent than when we use free weights for the same exercise. In summary, strength gains are specific to the type of external resistance that we use in training. However, this specificity is caused by three different types of specificity, all of which occur through adaptions that are stimulated by the conditions under which the muscle is trained. So we have joint angle specificity, we have velocity specificity, and we have the strength endurance continuum. And all of these different types of specificity contribute to the results that we see after strength training with different types of external resistance.